Hi there, welcome to part four of the video series, Telescope Basics. My name is David Fuller, host of the Eyes on the Sky weekly stargazing series that can be found on eyesonthesky.com. In this video, I will explain how field of view works in amateur telescopes, both apparent and telescopic fields of view, and why it's important to understand them. Let's start with the typical human eye. Most people have a field of vision that is on the order of about 160 degrees. That's nearly half a circle of view. In other words, you can see a lot. See the protractor? If your eyeball is here at the center, you've got most of the field of view of that. Not bad, eh? Glasses restrict this somewhat, but even those who wear them still have a wide field of vision. As a telescope magnifies an object, it restricts your field of view of what you see in the sky. But how much it does so is dependent on a number of factors. The first has to do with the eyepiece you use. Every eyepiece has an apparent field of view, or AFOV, and you can find information about various eyepieces' apparent fields of view on eyesonthesky.com. AFOV is equivalent to putting a circle in front of your eye and restricting your normal 160 degree field of view to something smaller. Let's take a typical 1.25 inch barrel, 25 millimeter Plossel eyepiece as an example. In most focal lengths, they have a 52 degree apparent field of view. Although this video camera cannot show the 160 degrees our eyes can see, if we restrict our vision to 52 degrees, we might see something like this. Now we place that eyepiece in our telescope. Let's go with a typical focal length telescope, say a 90 millimeter F10 refractor of 910 millimeters focal length. Now when we place the eyepiece in the telescope, we will not see 52 degrees of sky. Look at this diagram of 52 degrees versus the angle that light is bent in the telescope. There's no way it could show 52 degrees of sky, right? That is because the telescope is magnifying a section of sky via its focal length and aperture, or focal ratio. So we can roughly calculate what area of sky we will magnify in the telescope with a little math. The 910 millimeter focal length divided by 25 millimeter eyepiece yields a magnification of about 36 times. To get a rough idea of field of view, we now divide the apparent field of view of the eyepiece, which is 52 degrees, by the magnification, which was 36 times in this combination. So 52 divided by 36 is 1.4 degrees. So assuming that aperture is not being vignetted in some way, either from the dew shield, internal baffles of the telescope, or the focuser tube itself, we should see an approximate telescopic field of view of 1.4 degrees of actual sky in our eyepiece through the telescope, even though our eye perceives 52 degrees at the eyepiece. Now, this will change with telescope and with eyepiece. For example, this longer focal length scope using a 4 millimeter Ramsden eyepiece will show much less. Let's look at this math. 1200 millimeter focal length divided by 4 yields a 300 times magnification. With a 40 degree apparent field of view divided by 300 magnification, that yields a telescopic view of just 0.13 degrees. That's a tight field of view and will probably require a tracking motor, or the object will quickly move out of the field of view due to Earth's rotation. On the flip side, this 300 millimeter focal length telescope using this 16 millimeter Plossel eyepiece yields a magnification of 19 times. Since the apparent field of view is 52 degrees, we divide that by 19 and get a 2.7 degrees telescopic field of view, a nice wide field of view, large enough to see the entire Pleiades star cluster, or even the belt stars of Orion, though barely. So telescopic field of view is what small area of sky you will actually see. An apparent field of view is how large that field appears to your eye in the eyepiece. So that is a quick look at apparent and telescopic fields of view. In the fifth video, I'll tackle the subject of using Barlow's to increase magnification. And to see what you can find in the night sky this week, be sure to view the weekly Eyes on the Sky videos at eyesonthesky.com. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up.